going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we have another video with the F80. I absolutely just been enjoying this car so much. And I'm just waiting on some things from Burger Tuning, waiting for some things from Keys Motorsports, actually doing some things with ECS Tuning as well. So we're just waiting on a couple things. I'm also looking into some wheels for the car as well, because I'm just like, I just want to modify it so much. You guys already know I did the carbon fiber spoiler and the carbon fiber rear seat covers, but I mean, I'm just gonna go full ham. Probably thinking about some HRE wheels. So let me know what kind of HRE wheels. I mean, I'm obviously got like a limited budget, so we're talking like entry level. But yeah, we're still waiting on a couple things to come in. And in the meantime, I figured I might as well talk about the 5 reasons why I actually chose this and the 5 reasons. I'll probably make another video like 5 reasons why I don't like the car. I feel like that's gonna be super hard to do, but I wanna do the main video I wanna do right now is honestly the 5 things that I love about this car. So I think we should go ahead and get into it. So I don't know if you guys know, for those of you guys who are new to this channel, but this is an F80 M3 and it comes with the manual gearbox. When I had my E92 M3, I also came with the manual gearbox. When it comes to M cars, I just prefer the manual. I don't know why, I just honestly do. I just feel like you enjoy the car so much more. I owned a DCT M4 before, so it was pretty much the same car, but it was a DCT. It was honestly very, very, very fun, very quick and easy to handle. But I don't know why, something about the manual that makes me feel like I don't have to go quick to have fun. If you guys know what I mean, like with a DCT, I feel like I just have to be going my fastest to truly enjoy the car. While with a manual, just like going between gears is really, really, really fun. And the thing I wanted to mention, the number one thing why I absolutely love the F80s, at least the F80s and the F82s, is that their manuals come with auto rev match or like downshifting or something like, I think it's like rev matching. And basically when you put the car in efficient mode and you just go ahead and put it in third, go ahead and put it in second, as you're slowing down, it automatically revs up the car for you. Even in sport, it'll rev up the car for you, just make it super easy. So even if you guys have people in the car with you, you're not jerking the car around, trying to downshift, trying to do your thing, or even if you're trying to be smooth and ride the clutch, it has the option to where it just rev matches it for you and it just makes life super easy. Even when it comes to traffic and things like that, that's just one of the main reasons I love the manual on this. My E92 M3 did not have that, and let's just say it is just truly noticeable and I love it. And what I also love about it is if you're trying to go down to the track and you're just trying to, you know, try to rev match yourself, or you're not trying to rev match, you're trying to use the engine power itself to slow down the car, when you put it in sport, I think sport plus, it'll take away the rev match feature. I think you can go ahead and get that coded in as well if you want to have it in sport plus, but it has it already pre-coded out, so you can go ahead and do whatever you want in your full control when you're in sport plus. So yeah, the number one thing is definitely rev matching. The second thing about this car, honestly, is how easy it is to make power. It's crazy if you guys look at it, like Burger Tuning has a 600 horsepower kit, and you guys know this car comes with like 400, a little over 400 from the factory, and just with like a couple bolt-ons, you're pushing 600 horsepower very, very, very reliably. So that's what another thing I really like about this car is that you can honestly have supercar speeds with just like maybe like a couple $1,000. I'm talking maybe $2,000-$3,000 with proper bolt-ons, proper tune, and you're pushing 600 horsepower. So that is something you guys will definitely be seeing on this channel. I actually have plans to actually maybe even go stage 2 turbos on this because I'm keeping this long-term. Again, these are my plans. I don't know if it's actually gonna happen, but we'll have to see. Obviously, money is a concern, and I just picked this up and I spent all my money on it, but I mean, I absolutely love it, and that's again why I'm making this video. Now, the third thing I love about the F80s, and actually is in comparison to the M4s, is just how wide the F80s are compared to the M4s. The M4, honestly, if you bought like a 435 and put like an M4 body kit on it, I feel like, I mean, don't get upset with me, but I've owned an M4, and I genuinely feel like maybe because I had like the gray color, so maybe I couldn't tell with the curves as much as this color, but the F80, guys, is just so much wider. And I mean, obviously, when you guys get in that M car, you love the hips. The hips just look super good. It's super wide, and I just think it looks so good on this car. If you guys start getting an F30 and put an M3 body kit on it, it will never look like an M3, and that's one of the main reasons I love the M3. I mean, again, guys, look at those hips. Oh my lord. Now, the fourth thing I love about the F80 chassis in comparison to the E92 previous, chassis, was the fact that this chassis came 2015, 2016, came with a lot of options from the factory. For example, it comes with the manual gearbox from the factory. It comes with the Harman Kardon, Harman Kardon sound system from the factory. Comes with heated rear seats, heated front seats from the factory. Those are not additional options. The carbon fiber trim was not an additional option. It was absolutely free with this car. So it came with a lot of desirable packages and desirable options that the E92 M3, you had to actually pay for each individual thing. So yeah, the number four thing is just the fact that you get a lot of bang for the buck, honestly. You guys get a lot of things. I believe even the carbon roof is a standard feature. So you guys get a lot of bang for the buck with the F80 chassis. You get the big screen, you get all the options, you get navigation, all that stuff. Those are not additional things, which I really, really, really love about the F80. You get so much bang for the buck, and I'm not to mention a mean motor. I absolutely love this motor.
Also, talking about spec, that's actually one of the reasons I actually got an F80, and particularly this one. When I was looking to get an F chassis M car, when I between the M4 and the F80, when I got the M4, for those of you guys who are new to the channel, it was pretty much a gray exterior, I believe metallic gray with a black interior DCT. It was fairly plain. It did have the carbon roof, but I mean, for me, I just didn't feel too, like the car was too special in my opinion. I wish it had some kind of exclusive color or exclusive interior, something that kind of like just went for just the M cars. I love absolutely the Atlantis blue paint job. Like, this is like something that came from the factory. Absolutely love it. This is the thing that sold me on this particular F80, was the paint job. The red interior was another huge plus. The manual gearbox, which was an absolute must, and then the carbon roof. Like, this is just my absolute dream spec. Let me know down below what your guys' dream spec is, but this is absolutely my all-time favorite F80 spec. Now, if it had extended leather, I would have loved it a lot more, but I mean, it might have to do a retrofit, put an extended leather dash and a heads-up display. That's something kind of disappointed with. This car did not come with a backup camera or a heads-up display, so those were options you did have to spec out.
Now, the fifth thing that I absolutely love about the F80 chassis, and I mean, it's just what you guys see right there. It's the fact that it's four doors. The M4, I've owned a lot of coupe cars in my lifetime. I owned a couple 135s. I've owned an i8. M4, and the thing is, I mean, coupes are great and all, I love them. It's more sporty. Even my 435, I got it and I modified the baloney out of it. I had an E92 before, my E92 M3 obviously, so I loved coupes. It just feels more of a sporty vibe to it. But the thing is, I've noticed that I've always, like, you know, sometimes I have friends that want to come in the car with me and we have to take two cars, and one person driving their daily and I'm taking the E92 M3, and I just feel like it'd be a bunch of fun to actually have a car like this, for example, that you have more people that can fit in the back of you very, very, very comfortably.
If you guys look at the rear seats, guys, there's plenty of leg room back here. It has the heated seats, so people get to sit here comfortably with the heated seats. You have AC and these carbon overlays back here for the seats as well. Just look absolutely amazing. So yeah, I mean, I just think it's a great view. Definitely people back here can definitely enjoy the car just as much as the people in the front. And I just think, like, ultimately, like, just more people can just enjoy this car
more than you would get out of, like, a you know, like a coupe or something, either a two-seater or a four-seater. But the rear seats are, like, you know, people are gonna have to be pretty much scooching up to the front, if you guys know what I mean. So those are the top five things I absolutely, absolutely love about the F80. An honorable mention right before I conclude on the video is just its attributes. It's the fact that it's very reliable and the build quality is absolutely amazing. What I love about the F80 chassis, it does not feel like, I don't know, it just feels so much like it's very luxury for what it is. Like, BMW's always killed it with their cars. I've owned an E46, I've owned an E36, and those cars, as you slam the doors, kind of felt like a 350Z, everything shake. The E92 M3 was more sturdy, but it didn't feel as premium as the F80 is. The F80 is super, super, super premium, and honestly, I can't even feel the difference in terms of premiumness, if that's even a word, when you compare the F80 to the G80. I mean, they're both amazing cars. They both have their own unique and amazing interiors, but end of the day, in terms of quality, they're about the same, which I absolutely love. So again, you're getting a lot of bang for the buck. And in terms of reliability, some people say there's a crank up issues with these cars. Obviously, there possibly could be a crank issue. I did my crank up on my M4, and I'm thinking about doing it on the F80 as well, just because, you know, just that peace of mind. But other than that, these don't have like crazy leaking issues. I mean, everybody knows you have leaking issues, but this one, from the forums and everything, I've heard so many positive things about this car, and that's actually absolutely amazing. That makes me feel like in the long term, I'm not gonna be spending a bunch of money just trying to fix it up and, you know, just trying to get the car on the road all the time. Like my E92 M3, just a bunch of things are always breaking down on it, and I had to do the rod bearings, the throttle actuators are a thing. There's just so many things that could go wrong on the previous generation, while this one is just the six-cylinder twin turbo, and it's just, again, a very, very, very reliable car. So yeah, guys, those are my top five things I love about the F80 platform, and then one honorable mention. If you guys agree with me, let me know down below. If you guys actually have a couple other things that you think I should have mentioned, make sure to leave it down below so other people can read the comments. But yeah, guys, we're just waiting on the mods for the F80. I am super, super, super stoked to take this thing to the next level. I'm also posting a bunch of sick photos with this thing. I'm gonna be taking off photography. I'm gonna be trying to, you know, step up my game on my Instagram. So if you guys are not following me on my Instagram, make sure to check it out down below. Without further ado, guys, I love y'all so much. Remember to stay humble. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.